Hello friends, welcome back. My name is PK. In this video, you will learn how to create a comparative analysis dashboard in Microsoft Excel. I have created a comparative analysis dashboard in Microsoft Power BI. Already I have uploaded this video. Many viewers asked the question, can we create the similar dashboard in Microsoft Excel also? So using this same data set, I have created this in Microsoft Excel. In this dashboard, we are showing the current year sales and budgeted sales, then budget variance percentage, and we have used the conditional formatting. If it is in the positive, then it will be in green, otherwise it will be in red. Then here we are showing the PY sales, means the previous year sale, and we are showing here the year on year growth. Alright, so you can select the year from here, whatever year you will select, numbers will be changed automatically. And similarly, the color coding also will be changed. Alright. Then we are showing here month-wise trend for actual and budgeted sales. Then here you can see the comparison in this line chart. In this chart, we are showing current year versus previous year comparison. So here you can see, we are showing it by category. Cat 1, Cat 2, Cat 3, Cat 4. So first I would like to show you the data. In the data we have budget sheet. In the budget we have month, which is the start of the month, product ID and the budgeted amount. Then we have the product master sheet. Here we have the product ID, the product name, this is dummy name, and then product category, which is the dummy category. And you can see in one product category there are four products in the category 1. Then in the category 2 we have 3 products. Similarly in category 3 or category 4, so we have multiple products in one category. Now here we are showing the sales amount. So you can see in the sales amount we have date, product ID and sales amount. Alright, in this chart we have used the drill down and drill up options. So for example, we have CY sales for category 1. Now I want to see the product label detail for this category 1. Simply double click on any bar of category 1. Just double click here. Automatically this chart will be converted into product label chart, and these are the four products coming under category 1. Alright, so you can see it is by product. Now you can simply select any one bar here, right click and go to the drill down, drill up, and you can click on drill up or drill up to category label. Now again this is the same chart. Now let's say I want to see the chart for category 2. So I can simply double click here. If I want to drill up to the category level, simply right click. Or you can do one more thing, select any one bar, go to the pivot chart analyze, and here we have drill up button. So you can drill up to the category level or just click here. So it will be at category level. Alright. Similarly here in this chart, we have category wise budget. Now if you want to drill down, just double click on any slice, now it will be by product. You can simply right click and drill up to the category level. Alright, so that's how you can use the drill down and drill up here. Then we have budget versus actual sale by products. So we can compare by the product also. Alright, now quickly I'll show you how can you create this in Microsoft Excel using these three data points. So let's start without delay. Let me copy this data, just copy, press Ctrl N and just paste this here. So this is new workbook, and friends, this is a table. So you can see a table design here. It is table 1. You can rename this as budget. So this is the budget table. You can rename this here also. Now let's copy the product master also. Add a new sheet. Go to the table design. This here also, let's add one more sheet, which is sales. Paste this here, rename the table as sales. Now we will use the power pivot here. So friends, to learn how to use the power pivot, you can watch our power pivot playlist. I have explained from the starting how can you install this for Excel 2013 or 10. And how can you use this in the latest version of the Microsoft Excel. Alright, so here on the top you can see I have power pivot available in my Excel ribbon. Just click here and just select any one table. So let's say I'm selecting this budget table. Simply click on add to data model. Now it will open the data model window for power pivot. So this is for the budget. Let's come back to the another sheet. And this is the product master. Just add to data model. So we have two sheets here now. Let's go to the sales and click on add to data model. Okay, now let's add calendar table here. So we will create a calendar table. We'll go to the design and we'll go to the date table. And here we will create a new date table. Just click. So automatically it will create a calendar table here. So you can see it is creating calendar table. And automatically it has taken the different dates, year, month number, month, and then MMM, YYY format of the month, day of the week number, and day of the week. Alright, so we have these four tables with us. Now we will create the relationship. So come to the home tab, then go to the diagram view. Now in the diagram view, we have these four tables. So let's put our fact tables in the middle. So this is our fact table and this is our fact table. Okay. Now this is our dimension table. So let's keep this here. We have another dimension table, this one. Let's keep this here. All right. Now this month connect with this date, because in the month column we have start of the month, so ultimately it is a date, so we have connected with this one. Now this date, let's connect with the sales date, this one. Okay, so we have created this relationship. Now this product ID, just connect with product ID of the budget, and this product ID, just connect with the product ID of sales. All right so we have created this relationship, you can see. Now in the product, we will create a hierarchy, because we want to drill down and drill up. So what I will do, I'll create a hierarchy. So let's right click and just create a hierarchy here. So this is the hierarchy one. You can rename it as product hierarchy. Okay. And let's move the category also. Right click and just add to hierarchy and product. Okay, but category should come first, so just move this up. First is category, then we have the product name. Alright, so now our data model is completed. We will create few measures, so we'll create the measures from the sheet, not from here. So what I will do, I'll go to the pivot table and just create a pivot table. And let's create a pivot table on the new sheet. Click on OK. So this is sheet 4. Let's rename this as support sheet. Now we will create few measures. Okay, to create the measures, what we will do, we'll go to the measures here in the power pivot tab and just create a new measure and create this in the sales table. And let's create the first measure as CYC. Alright, and then we will take a variable CY. So let's take where CY equal to, and let's take the max year of calendar table. So in the calendar table we have year, let's take the max year here. Now return, and in the return we will use calculate, and we are taking the sum of sales. So use the sum of sales amount, this one, and where we can say the calendar year should be put here equal to CY. We have already taken the variable. Okay, so this will be our formula. Let's copy this formula and then let's change the formatting option also. So this will be our currency. So select here currency. Let's say in the dollar and decimal place, let's take 0. Click on OK. So this is our CY sale. We can see we have created one measure. Now let's create the new measure and let's create for the PY sale, previous year sale. Now in the PY sales, calculate sum of sales amount. Let's close this and just use same period last year. This formula, and here we will provide the dates, so we'll use here calendar date, this one, and just close this, and here again it will be a currency. Let's take zero decimal place, click on OK. Now let's create new measure, which will be my BioBuy group. I'll use here divide function, divide, and I'll use here CY sales. I have already created this measure, minus PY sale. This will be our numerator, comma, denominator will be my PY sales, comma, alternative result. Let's say I want to put here zero or blank, whatever you want to put, just put there. And this will be our percentage, because this is the growth. So in percentage will come in the number. So just select the number here, go to the format and select the percentage here. This one. Let's take the decimal as 0. Click on OK. Okay, so we have CY sales, PY sales and YOY sales growth with us. Now let's create two more measures. This new measure, and let's take the budget sale. Budget sales, we will simply take whatever we have taken for the CY sale. So let's put the same formula here. I have already copied this formula. The only difference will be, in place of sales amount, use here budgets. Let's take currency here, dollar and decimal. Click on OK. So we have created for the budget sale also. Now let's create the budget variance, new measure, and let's create budget variance, and we will use here again divide, and let's take CY sales minus budgeted sales, this one. This will be our numerator, denominator will be budget sales, this one, comma, alternative, let's take, just close this, and let's take the number and then take. So we have budget variance also with us. Okay, so we have created all the KPIs. So now let's move this value here. Let's keep this in the corner here. All right, so this is our first pivot table. Now let's save this file, press F12, and let me save this on the desktop for now. Okay, it is saved. So we have all the values here, which we will use on the card, like we have used this dashboard. Alright, then we will create this chart, which is actual versus budgeted sales by month. So let's create another pivot table. So you can just copy this and let's paste this here. And here we will take calendar month. Go to the more field and let's take the month name here in place of value. Let's move this here. Let's take month from the calendar table. Let's take the CY sale measure and budget sale measure. So let's take the CY sale here. Then you can search from here. Budget sale. And move this value here in the column. Alright, so we have this table ready, and using this table we will create this chart. The second chart, we will create the similar chart, but this will be by category and product. So we will use the drill down here and CY and PY sales. So let me copy this table and let's paste this here. And for this one, what we will do, right click, go to the show field list. We will use the product hierarchy. Okay, so we have already created a product hierarchy. So just go to the product master. Here we have this product hierarchy. Let's move the month from here and let's take the product hierarchy here. In place of budget, we will use the PY sale. So just type here PY sale, and this is the measure which we have created. So we have ready this pivot also. You can see this is the pivot. Now we can create the similar pivot for the budget. So just copy and just paste this here. And this time we will use the budgeted sales in place of CY sales. So just remove this CY and PY sale. Let's take the budgeted sale. All right, so this is also ready. Now the last one, we will use CY sale and budgeted sales by product. So let's use this here, just paste this here. So this will remain same. Only thing we will add here, CY sale. So just move this CY sale here. And if we don't want to take it by category, so let's take only product name here. So we can use the product name from the product master. Go to the more field, this product name. Okay, so this is also ready. So friends, we have created all the pivot tables which is required to create the charts. Now save this. This will be our support sheet, and now just add another sheet, and you can rename this as dashboard or whatever name you want to keep here. Now quickly I will show you how can you create this dashboard. First of all, let's go to the view and just uncheck the grid lines from here. Then go to the insert, and from the shapes you can insert this shape, which is two corner rounded rectangle, and just drag this here. Just keep this here. You can take any design whatever you want to take. So let's say I'm taking this one. You can make it little rounded. Alright, so here you can keep your title. Now let's insert another rectangle, but this time we will take the normal rectangle, this one, and just drag this rectangle here. Just keep this here. Alright, you can make it slightly bigger like this. Go to the shape format, shape outline, let's take this blue color, and for the shape fill we will take little lighter blue, let's say this one, and then right click and go to the format shape here. We will increase the transparency, so let's take 80% transparent, so it will look like this. Now you can add, now you can insert a text box here or word art, and here you can put your dashboard title, whatever title you want to keep, or let's take the font color as white, slightly smaller, or here font you can take the Arial. Whatever title you want to put, you can edit this, but here I have put the comparative analysis in Excel. You can put your logo also in left corner or in right corner. Now quickly I'll show you how can you create these cards. To create these cards, what you can do, you can simply insert small rectangle, let's take this rectangle, or here I have used the rounded corner, so you can take the rounded corner rectangle. So let's take this rectangle and just drag this here. So this will be our card like we have created in Power BI, this one, and here make it slightly bigger. Let's take the back color as white, this one. Outline, you can take this one. Go to the shape effects and then go to the shadow, and you can take this shadow offset center. All right now go to the insert and then go to the text and insert a text box here. This one you can put here, let's say CY sales, and just align the center and remove the background color. Go to the shape format, take the shape fill as no fill, shape outline as no outline, just move this here. Now make a copy of this and paste here and make it slightly bigger, and select this text box, go to the formula bar, press equal to, then go to the support sheet. So our CY sale is this one, just select this and hit the enter. Now it is reflecting here, make it slightly bigger. Bold. This is our CY sale. You can take in some other color also. Let's say if you want to take in blue color. Alright, so that's how we can connect this. Now let's go to the support sheet and let us insert a slicer for ear. So go to the insert and go to the slicer. It is for the active one, but go to the all, and here I'll go to the calendar and I'll go to the more fields and I'll take the ear from here. Click on. So this is the slicer for the year. You can take 4 or 5 column here, 3 or 4 column. Let's take 3. Okay. Slicer style you can choose from here. Let's say I'm choosing this one. Make it slightly smaller. And now if I will select, then you can see the numbers are getting changed. But this is only for one pivot, this one. So what we can do, we can right click, go to the report connections, And here you can see it is connected with pivot table 1 only. Just check for all. Click on OK. Now if I will select 1 year, then you can see all the pivots numbers are getting changed. Now select this slicer and press Ctrl X to cut this. Then go to the dashboard sheet and paste this slicer here. Now let's keep this slicer here. Alright, now we will create the other cards like we have created here in this Excel, these cards. So let me quickly create for the budget sales, budget variance, PY sale and YOY sales growth. Alright, so what I will do, I'll select these three boxes, copy and paste, keep this here. Okay, I have created these 5 boxes. I'll quickly rename the text as we have taken in this dashboard. Okay, now if you want to change the color for these text boxes also, font color, let's take this blue. Alright, now what we will do, quickly we will connect with the relative cell for the budget sales. We will connect it with budget sale, come to the sheet, and budget sale is this one. Press enter. It is connected with the budget sale. For the budget variance, as equal to, and just connect it with this sales. Enter. Similarly for PY sale. Now we have to apply the same formatting, so just select this box, double click on the format painter available in home, and just click here, click here, click here, click here. Now friends, if I will select any other year, you can see all the numbers are getting changed. The only thing, the color are not getting changed for these 2%. So let's put a conditional formatting. If it is positive, then it should be in green. If it is negative, then it should be in red. To put the conditional formatting, we will use a trick. So let's come to the support sheet first. Let's insert here one column. Let's take these two columns. So let's put here for red and this should be. Now for this one, we will put here a condition. If this value is less than 0, then we will put this value as we put here blank. Let's format this in percentage. For the green, we will use here, if this value is greater than or equal to 0, then it will show this value, otherwise it will show blank. And again, format this is as percentage. Copy this and just put for the budget variance. Now we will come to the dashboard and let's copy these two boxes, make a copy of this. For now just keep this here. Okay, now let's connect this first. Press equal to, come to the support sheet. So let's connect with red, press enter. Similarly this one, connect with red. This is why UI says code, sorry. This should be connected with C6. Okay, so this is for red. Now this one just connect for green, then come to the support sheet, click here for the budget variance. So it is showing blank because that cell is blank. Similarly here, press equal to, come to the support sheet, like this, press enter. All right now this is for red. Now select these two text boxes, come to the font color and take as red. Make this bold slightly bigger. Let's take Arial font or Arial rounded empty so that it will be properly visible. Alright, now let's take another year, that's 2019. So here you can see it is not visible because this will be now, this red will be blank, green is visible. Okay, so here we will take in green color, so let's take this one, this bold, slightly bigger, here you'll have the empty bold, format this here. Now we will move this slightly here. Alright, now if I will select 2020, then you can see it is showing these number, otherwise it is showing these number. Okay friends, so that is how you can use the conditional formatting. Now quickly I'll show you how can you create these chart. So first, actual versus budget sales. Come to the support sheet. This is actual versus budget sale. So select this pivot, come to the insert, and let's come to the charts and select a line chart. Let's take this one, which is line with marker. Now select the chart, come to the pivot chart analyze, and here in the field button we'll use the hide all. Now select the legend, right click, go to the format legend. You can keep the legend at bottom so that it will be visible properly. Click on this plus button and enable the chart title. Just rename the chart title as actual versus budget sales. Just make it slightly smaller. You can format the chart as per your requirement. For now I'm just keeping it as it is. But if you want to make it rounded corner, simply right click, go to the format chart area and just come to the border part, and here you can make it rounded corner. And if you want to give some shadow also, you can come to the format and then come to the safe effects shadow, and let's take this shadow which is offset center. So select this chart, press Ctrl X and come to the dashboard. You can paste this chart here. Let's keep this here. Come to the charts element, and here you can add the grid lines, the vertical grid lines also, so it will look like this. Alright. Okay, now you can create the another chart also, like we have created here this CY versus PY sale. So what you can do, you can copy this chart and press Ctrl N, new workbook, and paste this chart here. So you don't need to create all the formatting again, that's why I'm doing this. So I have copied it to the book 2, new workbook. I'll copy this again and I will paste back to that sheet. Why I have done this? Because now I can connect this chart with the another pivot. Simply right click, go to the select data. Here you can see I am able to select the chart data range here. But in this chart, I cannot change the data range. You can see this is disabled. Okay. So in this chart, what I will do? I'll go to the chart data range and just click here so that cursor will be visible. Come to the support sheet, and this chart we want to create category wise CY versus PY. So just click here anywhere on this pivot and click on it. Okay, so this is line chart. We can change the chart as column chart. Just select the chart, come to the design and click on change chart type, and here you can select the column, select the first one, click on it. Okay, so this is the chart category, and automatically drill down option is enabled. If I will double click, then you can see it is showing by product, because I have used here the product hierarchy. Okay, so that's why the drill down is enabled. You can adjust this chart slightly here. Alright, you can just drill up, select any one bar, right click, drill up to the category. Okay, now rename this, it is CY versus PY sale. Now just copy this chart again. You can paste on the new workbook anywhere, let's say here, and again copy this and paste it back to the same dashboard. So why I am doing this, I will be able to change the reference. Right click, go to the select data, and here you can see now I am able to select the reference. Come to the support sheet, and this time I will select this table. Click on OK. Now change the chart type. So go to the design, change chart type, let's take the donut chart. So come to the pie and let's take this donut. You can right click here, go to the format data series, change the donut hole size up to the 85%. And this is for the budget. Alright, now for the last chart, what we can do, just make it slightly bigger. You can make a copy of this chart, which is CY versus PY. And then you can paste this here. It is already here, so you can just copy and paste this here. Again, paste it back. Make it slightly bigger like this. Right click, go to the select data. Come to the support sheet. Scroll it right and connect with this pivot. Click on OK. This is actual versus budgeted sales. So you can copy this type. Alright. You can just select this chart. If you want to show one line and one bar, so let's say for budget I want to show the line, just select this chart, go to the design, change chart type, and here you can come to the combo. In the combo it will automatically will show one line and one column. You can change it as per requirement. Let's say I want to take the line with marker. Alright friends, so friends, that's how you can create this comparative analysis dashboard. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Friends, if you like this video, please hit the like button and please subscribe my channel to get the regular update of my videos. Thank you so much for watching.